Hello, how about good morning, good afternoon, good night? I'm Ahani Ruiz, engineer of Peruvian mines that promotes and disseminates RecMin Mining Software through me online platform SoMin, where I offer you language training. Spanish, English and Portuguese, and also from face-to-face in Latin America. Okay. Here right now I'm going to teach you how to update the topography of the mine of your project with mining software RecMin D. Simple and easy way if in case you have or are you driving a mine topography project and not have a budget to acquire a commercial software license, because with RecMin you can do it without problems. How are you seeing right now have two topography surface layers. You have an initial topography and you have another topography of broken ground as you are seeing it here, and what we need to do is merge those two topographies or update the topography to not have to do a survey at all. This area or this whole area, that's very easy, it's very simple, simply you are worth of the button to draw lines or polygons, okay? And we are going to carry a line roughly on the edge of the topography of the broken terrain. It has to be to the limit, it does not have to be outside, but inside it can be a square, can be a polygon, what you want, not. There's a problem here, the idea is that this line go to the edge of this one. Topography of the broken ground, okay, and when you finish here you order him to draw as a line. Here you do not need a coordinate in particular, nothing, simply you give accept and here in gradient, you agree, and you can put a name, Selena, the one you want. For example, update line, I will write it right now in Spanish language, right, redraw, and then there you have the line, and with this button we will not change color, so you can visualize it, for example, red color, and let's redraw, and then there you have the update line. Then what you are going to do next is go to layers of surfaces and let's disable one of the layers, for example, let's deactivate the topography of the pit or of the broken ground, and what we are going to do, it's a cut to this inner part of the polygon to leave a kind of gap or empty there to put the new topography. And that's very easy, you go to toolbar of the lines, and on this button that says edit lines, click here, and you realize that the vertices are activated of this polygon. Remember that it has to be a polygon, as to say a closed line, click on any of the vertices and shows you a menu of screen, and you're going to use the option to trim active surfaces, okay. Here the program asks you which surface wants to cut, if the inside or the outside. Then you use option 2, which is the part which is inside the polygon. Click on accept. Then in this message that says, if you want to add the line as outline, you're going to say no and wait. And the program is going to cut you to the surface, then redraw, and there you have. Then you have a new layer that it would be the clipping of the initial topography. Then you will do the opposite. We'll activate the topography of the broken terrain. Let's activate, and also let's do a cut here. Exactly in a limit to that polygon, the edit button has to be activated, and click any of the greens, and you're going to use the same option. In this case, you are going to order me to take away what is outside the polygon, that is, these pieces of surfaces that are coming out of the polygon. So use option 1, and you accept, and here again you click where it says no, so it does not draw the line as outline, okay. Very good, there is redraw, and now if you already have a new layer of the cut of the cut. So we have two cuts of both the initial topography, such as the terrain broken, and what we do is activate the two cuts, okay. And you forget the initial topographies, click on redraw, and we go to the button of lines and deactivate it. Is more, you can delete it to erase it. It's very easy, you just erase it with right click and tell him to delete, okay. Very good, redraw, and there you have the new topography already almost updated. We can look at it in 3D. We click on the 3D button. Now what I would have to do, it's just joining those two surfaces to make it a single layer, and that's very easy. If you want, you can leave separate as you have it there right now, but here in RecMin it's usually work by joining these two layers or these two surfaces. Down you have a button on the object button that says merge layers active, you will click and accept, and now you have only one topography. You can see that he joined in one. You can change color I'm going to put you, for example, red color, then redraw and there you have the new topographic surface. Okay, and now it is already very easy. You can triangular, but before that, I always recommend saving as a new file. We will call it final topography, and now we're going to triangulate for it. We go to the Settlint T3 menu, and here it is, the option that says triangular surfaces. Let's click on this option, and we click on this other option. Okay, and we click on triangular. This delay depending on the size of the object. For example, here right now we have a topography from 1 kilometer to 800 meters approximately, and also depends on the quantity. A vertex that have the surface. Okay, and this how you see is already triangulated. We can look at it in 3D now to see how it was. If you have there now a set of triangles, a file of triangles, that you can see it completely in 3D. Okay, here we can turn off now the surface to see how the T3 is. Okay, very good then of that way the topography of the mine is updated, and so you can keep updating weekly, daily way according to as the ground is broken or as it deepens, and you can go update and update the topography and saving the results by dates. Alright, that what I wanted to teach you here with RecMin. There are many things, more details, like, for example, calculate the area of all this, volume, make cuts, etc., but that's already teaches in an advanced course, which this is exactly what my work is, and I get some. Well, if you want to know more information, you can enter the RecMin page, www.recmin.com, and if you want to download the software, remembers that the download and installation is free. You can go here, download also updates, helps, beta versions, everything you want. You also have a business option. You have control of fleets, reports manager, etc. This from the control of fleets is very good, would be ideal that you try it in your mind, but it is a commercial application. You could request shows so you can see its operation in the mine. You have more images or more information about the fleet control APK. Okay, then here you also have information about courses. Here you have a free course. You can sign up there, you click, and you can receive more information. If you want more information about me, can you write me directly to eresdatsomean.com/imperatives, and I will be happy to answer you any restlessness or queries. Remember then, disseminate the RecMin program. It is very powerful software that really does not, they have nothing to envy commercial software. I encourage you to recommend it. It is in language English and Spanish, so there's no problem in that part. And if your job has not yet software and you're a mining engineer, geologist or mine surveyor, so I recommend you implement the RecMin. Will help you a lot in your jobs that you have there in your project. Okay, a hug. Thank you very much for listen to me, and remember to like this video and share it so that others, people and professionals like you know of this kind RecMin software. A hug. See you.